They said this day would never come. They said our sights were set too high. They said this country was too divided, too disillusioned.
A minute have I had since you've come my way. I hope you know I'd gladly go anywhere you take me. It's so amazing to be alive. I'd follow you to the moon and the sky above.
What's good, YouTube? I just wanted to make a video today because today is the big day, January 20th, 2009. Barack Day is what I'm calling it. Or maybe I should call it Obama Day, but I like the name Barack, so Barack Day. I just wanted to make my mark today, make my video and post it so I can document history and my personal life and my personal family, also along with YouTube. And I don't have a lot to say. I just want to say how proud I am of Barack and Biden. I'm so proud. I'm so happy. I hate to say so many times, but it's like when you're making these videos, you kind of forget what you're going to say. You got it all planned out, and as soon as the camera, it just all flies away. But I'm watching this inauguration. I just got home. You know, I was partying in Virginia this weekend, you know, and I was, you know, able to see all the stuff for the inauguration, but I had to come home, so I wanted to just make this video and say how proud I am of Barack Obama, Michelle Obama, Malia Obama, and Sasha Obama. And I'm also proud of the Biden family because, you know, like they've been saying all this time, we did it, we did it. Yeah, we did it. And this is very, very important. This is not just a special event for people like me of African descent, but it is a special event for everyone across the world. As you saw when the videos they released the night that Barack won, November 4th, 2008, and you looked at the videos and the pictures of the people all over the world celebrating. They were celebrating and partying harder than Americans, and it's not even affecting them. So that goes to show you the type of effect that this man has on the public. I'm watching him, you know, in his car, in that Cadillac, you know what I'm saying? And then him and Michelle got out, they walking, you know, waving at everybody. It's just wonderful. It's just wonderful because I'm 37 years old, and even though I know a lot of people that are older than me, you know, I'm old, I'm young or whatever to them, but to me, in my lifetime, I never would have thought that it could have really happened. You know, like, it was like, I know we can do it, but I never thought the powers that be would allow it to happen. But it happened, you know what I mean? Obama, he worked his magic, and his color did not affect it, and you know, that's good in America, because America is a racist country. It is, and it's built on racism, and almost everything in America is based on racism. Even though somebody doesn't come out and say, oh, you're a nigger, or whatever the situation is, there it's a lot of things built on racism in America. And people pretend like they don't know it, and they don't see it, and make excuses for it, you know, because if this person is this color, then it's okay for you to be treated that way, and if they're that color, then you're supposed to have sympathy, you know, and all that kind of mess. So this is very, very, very important, very, very historical day. And for all you haters on YouTube with the negative comments and the negative things like you did on my last videos that I did about Obama, keep it to yourself. Because just like I said before, that he was going to win, and he won, He won. So then I made the video saying I voted. And you know, all those videos, and I got all the little nasty remarks. Keep that stuff to yourself, because this is a day of celebration. And nasty, negative, or ignorant remarks will be deleted. But first, I'm going to comment and embarrass you. Then I'm going to block you. Okay? So, that's all I have to say. Love you, Brock. Love you, Biden. And let's just do this for the next 4 years. Hopefully, it'll be 8. But for the next 4 years, let's do it. Don't let nobody make you feel like, you know, you're not doing good enough, because this is a big old mess that one person cannot fix in 4 years. You know, so let's just keep that real. This is a mess. This is a mess of the American people. Allowed this fool back in office for the second time, and now everybody's crying about it. So this is a big, big mess that it's going to take a long time to fix. And we can't expect miracles overnight. You know, he's going to be judged harshly, you know, for things, a little bit more harshly. So we got to be on the lookout for that. But anyway, this is a very, very important day, very special day. I'm very proud to be an American today. And I just wanted to make my mark in history. And I'm trying to watch the inauguration at the same time I'm talking to you guys and watching family members and things like that. But I wanted to make my mark in history today. I already uploaded my picture on, the Obama photo bucket website. You were supposed to take a picture at the time of the inauguration, at the time of the swearing in at noon, and upload it to show what you were doing at the time. So that was what I did. Well, anyway, I'm going to call it quits because I'm going to finish watching this. I wasn't able to stay for the inauguration as I had planned, but I'm just as happy, even though I would have loved to have been there. When I look at the crowds, I'm glad I'm not in D.C. with that traffic. That would have been a killer. That would have killed my happy buzz. But anyway, congratulations, America. I'm going to say it one more time. We did it. We did it. And I also want to say happy birthday to my Uncle Booker. B-O-O-K-E-R. My Uncle Booker, which is his birthday is tomorrow. We threw him a surprise 50th birthday party over the weekend in Virginia. He actually lives in Germany. So all I have to say is his wife is good, because you can't get me from one town to the next, because I'm going to ask 50,000 questions. She got this mug from Germany to Virginia for a surprise party, and he didn't even know. So he kind of had an idea, because he's nosy like that, but he didn't know. But anyway, and also his son Brian, who was in Iraq, he's my first cousin. He came home, and it's also his birthday tomorrow. So we were celebrating both, you know, the homecoming of my cousin. I also have an uncle that's in Iraq. His name is Ricky, or should I say Marlo Tatum. He's still there, and I'm praying for him. I have an aunt, her birthday is January 24th, Cece, and I look just like her, so even though I'm named after my aunt Paulette, I'm basically a little Cece too. So, that's all I have to say. Any other January birthdays? I have a sister named April, her birthday was January 15th, she was born on Martin Luther King's birthday, and he died in April. He was assassinated in April, so that's why my mom named her April. Her birthday was April. I'm sorry, her birthday was January 15th. I have a niece. Her name is Dominique. Her birthday was January 8th. And my god sister, Kasha, her birthday was also January 8th. My uncle Ricky, that is in Iraq, his birthday was January 9th. So I want to say happy birthday to everybody. Anybody that I have forgotten, please charge it to my head, not my heart. Didn't, you know, mean to forget you. Just want to hurry up and close this video, because like I said, I want to make my mark today. You know, out there in cyberspace, you know, to show that this is an important day for me. This is an important day. When I'm not here, my kids will be able to look at this video and say, my mom made a video the day that, you know, our first black president was sworn in, and they can always, always, always get and go back and look at it. I won't be here, but technology will. So that's all I have to say. Everybody be blessed, and let's just enjoy the next 4 years. Obama, baby. Peace.